Hey guys, right here I have a 2012 Volkswagen Tiguan 2.0 TSI 4Motion. And today, I'm gonna make a startup and full vehicle tour video of it, show you the features, inside and out. So, here's the key. Let's go ahead and start it up first. This car only has 53 kilometers. Nice leather steering wheel with sport grips on the side. This car comes with a 7-speed direct shift gearbox, otherwise known as DSG. Essentially what it is that it's a dual clutch automated manual transmission with two sets of clutches. Clutch number 1 controls gears 1, 3, 5 and 7, and clutch number 2 controls gears 2, 4 and 6. DSG allows for smoother shifts as well as less slack between shift times. DSG also eliminates the need of a torque converter for a conventional automatic transmission, as well as a clutch pedal for a conventional manual transmission. It also has sport mode, as well as Tiptronic manual shifting via the plus and minus down there, or the pedal shifters on the steering wheel. Also, when you put the car in reverse, apart from the parking sensors activating, there'll also be a reverse camera that shows up on the screen. Parking sensor display. Your brightness contrasted color. Or just turning off the sound. Right down here, you have your parking brake. It's currently engaged, put your foot on the brake, push it down to disengage it, and pull it back up to engage it back. You also have an auto hold function for the parking brake. The auto hold function works in a way whereby if you have it turned on, and say you're at a traffic light, the car is in drive, and you lift your foot off the brake, the car won't move forward or roll back. Alright, so let's go ahead and turn on the hazards. Lights, front and rear fog lights, there are automatic lights and wipers on this one. All four windows are automatic. Indicators on the side mirrors. New Orleans alloy rims. To open the bonnet, you actually have to get to the passenger side and pull this lever. Auto leveling by xenon headlights with static and dynamic cornering light, as well as LED daytime running lights. The LEDs aren't actually flashing like that, it's just a problem with the camera. Front fog lights. Headlight washer system. This car has a 2-liter dual overhead cam 16-valve turbocharged inline 4 with direct injection. The engine produces 210 horsepower, from 5300 to 6200 RPM, and 280 Nm of torque from 1700 to 5200 RPM. The car has a top speed of 213 km an hour with a 0 to 100 km an hour time of 7.3 seconds. The car has a 64-liter fuel tank with a combined fuel consumption of 8.6 liters per 100 kilometers, and the carbon dioxide emissions rating for this car is 199 grams per kilometer. The car employs VW's 4Motion all-wheel drive system.
Rear parking sensors, dual exhausts, that's your rear fog light. Speaker, storage area, cup holder right here. Window controls, like I said, all of them are automatic. Window lock, mirror controls, central locking. Storage area. This adjusts the brightness of your interior at night. Headlight controls. And the driver's seat in this car is fully powered. This is for your seat back. This is for your seat position, seat height, inclination of the seat, and this is for your power lumbar. Alright, so let's go ahead and see how she revs. Right here, you have your Climatronic Dual Zone Automatic Climate Control System, your fan speed, automatic air conditioning. Dual means if you have it off, the driver's side will control both sides, but if you have it on, each side will have individual controls. Your front and rear defrost, recirculation, different modes, heated seats for the driver and front passenger. Your climate control data will also show up on the screen itself. And right up here, you have your RCD510 head unit. Your sound system settings. Your auxiliary USB, SD card, CD, FM, AM, CD player is MP3 compatible. You tune radio stations using this knob right here. It also shows up down here. Power folding mirrors. Wiper controls. Indicator and cruise control. Steering wheel audio controls. Mute, volume to change between your different tracks or radio stations. This set of up, down, left, right, OK, and return button actually controls the multi-information display in the instrument cluster. Up and down controls between your different sub-menus, while left and right controls between your different main menus. Right now, your speed, all temperature, speed warning, elapsed time, instant fuel consumption, average fuel consumption, range, distance travel, average speed, audio. You can change your different tracks or different radio stations. Your vehicle status. Your vehicle settings such as your language, lights, units, time. Hold your breath, because tonight will be the night that I will fall for you over again. Don't make me change my mind. I won't. Steering wheel is tilt and telescopic. You adjust it using this lever right here. We have a small little storage hole right there. Ashtray, cigarette lighter, power outlet. Storage hole down there as well. Traction control. Another storage hole here. Cup holders. Auxiliary. Power outlet. Central storage area, and there's actually a separate cable that plugs in right here that gives you your USB port, adjustable armrest, auto dimming, rear view mirror, sunglass holder. So I guess that's it for the startup. We can turn it off right now and continue with the rest of the tour. storage hole right there. Speaker. Window control. Seats do fold, just pull this lever. Use the same lever to adjust the angle of your backrest. You have sort of like a picnic table right here. Storage pockets on the front seat backs, rear aircon vents, power outlet, cup holders, right here. Hook. Now there are a couple of ways that you can open up the rear hatch. That's the button on the key fob. Or that's the touchpad right underneath here that opens it up. You also have your reverse camera right there. Decent amount of boot space, spare tire, power outlet, extended amount of boot space with your rear seats folded down. And the cargo cover is removable as well. You do have adjustable headrests, front and rear. Front passenger seat is manual. This is for your seat back, this is for your lumbar, this is for your seat height, and this is for your seat position. Storage tray right beneath the seat. Quite a deep glove box. Alright, so let's start it up with the door closed. Alright, so that's it for the startup and full vehicle tour video of this 2012 Volkswagen Tiguan 2.0 TSI 4Motion. Thanks for watching, and goodbye.